this. As my colleagues know, I have been fighting aggressively to get the Department of Interior to recognize that a 10-mile, one-lane gravel road to be used for non-commercial uses so that the people of King Cove, the Aleut community of 700 and some odd people, can access our state's second longest runway to get out of town when an emergency or a crisis approaches. And Fish and Wildlife Service came back and said no action alternative is the way that we're going, no road is needed. But in the 2009 law that we passed through this committee, it recognized that there needed to be a public interest determination as to that road. Well, when we're talking about public interest, it's not just the public interest of the land, it's not just the public interest of the waterfowl or the animals that may be in the area, it is the public interest of the people. And through many, many, many conversations now with Secretary Salazar, and through a very important meeting that was held here in Washington, D.C., where residents of King Cove were able to meet with the Secretary for the first time to outline their case as to why they should be heard, why their public interest needs to be accommodated in these decisions, the Secretary has agreed to take a second look, to revisit, if you will, the EIS that was conducted by Fish and Wildlife Service. He has directed that the Assistant Secretary of Indian Affairs go out to King Cove and meet with the people and put in place a process for better understanding as to what the public safety needs of the residents of King Cove are. He's further directed that the Secretary of Interior, whether it be Ken Salazar or whether it be Sally Jewell, go to King Cove to visit with the people to allow for a process for further information, a public process that will consist of testimony, of input, of really attempting to hear the public side. These are important for that process, and they will be factored into a final determination. But at this point in time, no record of decision will be issued until a public process is completed. I appreciate the Secretary's willingness to work with me on this. But again, as I mentioned in my opening comments when Sally Jewell came before this committee, we all have our King Coves. We all have a situation when we're working with or sometimes against our federal agencies and we don't feel like we're being heard. And sometimes the conversations need to go a little bit deeper. Sometimes we need to press a little bit harder to ensure that the interests of our constituents are addressed, whether it's the Aleut people of King Cove, whether it's the people who are out in the West who are worried about an interpretation of the protections for a sage grouse, whether it is my colleague from West Virginia who's worried about the interpretation of what a stream is. These are significant for each of us.